and welcome back to Doctor Who's Crown Jewels, the series where I go over every Doctor Who season, and maybe some other things too, and pick out the best from each of them. The Crown Jewels, if you will. So season 2, which recently got a Blu-ray, is a really good season. Heck, I think all the 60 seasons are really good. Season 2 reaches quite similar heights to the first season. Each story ranges from pretty good to phenomenal, with the exception of the web planet, but let's not go there. This season was the first season to introduce companion departures and, well, brand new companions, with all of the companions involved and the Doctor himself really good, top form, I would say. So there was a lot of changes happening throughout this season, but there were still a few constants, like William Hartnell as the lead role, Verity Lambert as producer. I would say the MVP of this season is Dennis Spooner. While yes, I feel like David Whittaker's contributions were still very good, as were Terry Nation's as well, just like last season, the two best stories of this season were both penned by Dennis Spooner. Those were The Romans and The Time Meddler. I would say, if I had to go for honorable mentions, it would be those two low-key stories, Planet of Giants and The Rescue. The former being an interesting sci-fi concept, with the plot revolving around a pesticide, with the tensions in our leads being quite good, as well as keeping your interest for 3 weeks. I think if they did have a part four, I'm glad they scrapped that. The Rescue was a simple two-parter to introduce the new companion Vicky, and the characterization of her is not only superb, but the villain's relation to her is very fascinating, and the characterization of the leads after the departure of Susan is also quite interesting. But without any further dilly-dally, let me briefly talk about the Crown Jewels. The Roman starts off with the TARDIS tumbling over a cliff, and then everyone just goes on holiday, and they live life like the Roman upper class. They're not actually in Rome at this point, but the Doctor and Vicky then go to Rome, get mistaken for a musician, and then the Doctor has to play for Nero. Meanwhile, Ian and Barbara get abducted by slave traders. Ian proceeds to become a gladiator, and Barbara proceeds to become a slave in Nero's courthouse. So that's the basic plot. The stuff to do with the Doctor and Nero is the comedy aspect, and it very much feels like the sort of vibe of a Carry On film. The actor that played Nero, I can't remember his name, I'm sorry, he was utterly terrific and hamming it up so much, but so was William Hartnell. This is easily my favourite performance William Hartnell did as the Doctor. He's clearly enjoying every second of the script. He gets into a fight and enjoys it. He tells a story to Vicky, and Maureen O'Brien can't contain her laughter, pretends to play the lyre, Emperor's New Clothes style, and fools everyone, somehow. Hartnell in this story is honestly a delight to watch, and is worth watching the story for on its own. The rest of the regulars are really good, and what they get to do is really interesting, and you also learn quite a bit about Roman culture and slave ownership and all that jazz. It does what a historical is meant to do, whilst also providing thorough entertainment. I do feel like this was the catalyst for the end of the historicals eventually, because they were trying to experiment with it here because they realised not many people were that interested in them, so why not try and make this one a comedy this time so more people would be entertained, like the children would be. But I would say this story's really good, despite it being a Dennis Spooner script and there being some historical inaccuracies as a result. Spoiler alert for the end, but I love the irony that although the Doctor was telling Vicky not to meddle with history and Vicky almost poisoning Nero, the Doctor himself kind of inspires Nero to burn down Rome. Although as a historical event that happened, he doesn't take that irony. Which is funny considering he takes the moral high ground in The Time Meddler, which is the other story, and my favourite story of the season. I love them both, but much like the Aztecs in Season 1 beating Marco Polo for me, I felt like it'd be unfair to not mention both, even though I do definitely prefer one over the other. The Time Meddler is another historical set during the beginning of the Viking invasion of England in 1066, an invasion that would eventually fail due to King Harold. However, fending off the Vikings made it so that he didn't do so well against William the Conqueror. Now, this is the first story with Stephen, and it's an interesting take on a companion introduction, given that he already appeared in The Chase the week prior. But here he has all the proper introduction stuff, such as being introduced to the TARDIS, being introduced to the fact that it can time travel. However, he was always skeptical. He's paired up with Vicky throughout most of the runtime, and they make a good double act. Vicky being the sort of straight-faced yet naive person trying to coax Stephen into believing their fantastical story, while Stephen is very overconfident, quite arrogant, quite patronizing, but in the end, wrong about his assertions. He is proactive, but he ends up fighting people when they really shouldn't be fought. Which is a nice contrast to Ian, who was more of a just hero that always fought when it was necessary. I do feel like it was an interesting take to like make Stephen sort of unlikable, but I do feel like Peter Purvis gets away with it through his mere charm. And he's not meant to be seen as in the right, because we have Vicky, who we know to be very much a morally just person, very much being against what Stephen does in this story. So I do feel like that balancing act does work out. Well, it doesn't help Vicky in her case to try and convince Stephen of them being in a time machine, is that they find anachronisms throughout, such as a Saxon having a watch. That is because there is some time meddler running amok in Saxon England. That would explain the title of the story, actually. This time meddler is the Meddling Monk, a fellow Time Lord, which we find out later in the story due to the fact that he owns a TARDIS. His plan is to destroy the Viking fleet before it gets to England, saving King Harold the job of fighting them off, so he can be well, fully fit to fight off William the Conqueror. Merely because the monk feels like King Harold would be an excellent king. The Doctor knows that this is a complete irresponsibility. This is not how the web of time is supposed to flow. This would destroy history as we know it, considering it would have a complete domino effect. I did say the Doctor was irresponsible before, and you could consider this a kind of plot hole, given that it may be a bit out of character. But I feel like with the whole vibe of 62, and especially the Verity Lambert era of the show, it was quite casual, yet very much the link of the main characters from story to story is what made it strong and made you invested. And the continuity was also fairly strong. So I feel like it gets away with this. I think what makes the Time Meddler really good is that it sets up a mystery, it gives you little snippets to try and figure out what's going on, it gives you a nice twist, and yeah, it's honestly a very well-structured four-parter. I don't really have anything else to say. I mean, it's a very strong story with very strong characters. The side cast is also very good, with the Saxons and the Vikings and the Meddling Monk, who, I must say, Peter Butterworth was perfect for the role. He's essentially the perfect antithesis for what the Doctor is, even more so than the Master, in my opinion. So getting an actor who is perfectly able to embody that comic side, whilst also being able to embody being a member of the Doctor's race, it makes a lot of sense to cast an actor like Peter Butterworth. But yeah, I've not got much else to say. What are your thoughts on Season 2? Do you think the Web Planet is the best one? Do you think any of the other stories deserve to be on here? Let me know in the comments down below. Chances are you'll probably agree with me. The Romans and the Time Meddler are fairly popular. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And stay tuned for Crown Jewels Season 3. I'll see you next time. Cheerio.